2 years ago, I put some soil and some plants inside of this jar and I sealed it so it was airtight. And throughout that time, I haven't opened it. No air has gotten in or out. And I've watched as plants lived and died. And that whole time, I've been wondering, how much bigger would a jar need to be that it was just big enough that a human, like me, could survive inside of it? And so I just finished building this. It's a 30,000 liter jar, and I'm going to seal myself inside of it and see how long I can survive on the inside. So the frame is made out of wood, and I've covered it in greenhouse plastic. There is one continuous sheet of plastic going the whole way around, and then I wrapped it like a present of danger.
It's happening.
I sealed the outside with duct tape, and then I sealed the inside with duct tape, and then I went over everything that I thought might be a gap with silicone. So it is airtight. But the interesting stuff is inside, so I'm gonna give you a tour of that. So this is my biodome. It is filled with about 200 plants, about 80 liters of water. I've got a bunch of air monitoring equipment over here and a cactus that you might be familiar with. There is a hammock over here, my nice little resting nook. I've got some lights that are mostly just for me. I built in an airlock because maybe there'll be something that I forgot to bring in, but this way I can open my side and put something in to give to them and then seal it and they can open their side or vice versa. As long as one is always closed at a time, then less than half a liter of air will get out or in. Don't want air getting in, right? I should say, do not try this at home. In case you're wondering just how dangerous this is, I actually asked Patrick Kelly from the YouTube channel Corporis.
Hey, so this whole thing seems like a terrible idea, right? Like something was bound to happen to Kurtis's body. Well, if you're interested in the human physiology at play and some of the safety precautions that he took going into it, you can go ahead and click on that eye right there to see that video over on my channel Corporis.
I know a lot about biology, but not that much about human biology, and that is what he's an expert in. And also, I didn't particularly want to make a video about all the ways that this could kill me, because I want to sleep at night. This is one of the most important sensors in my experiment. It measures oxygen. Oxygen is the reason that we breathe. But as you can see, the air we breathe is only about 21% oxygen, and that's because most of the air, over 78% of it, is nitrogen. So while our atmosphere is mostly nitrogen and oxygen, it's that remaining 1% that I am most interested in and most concerned about, because those gases can be deadly. But I'm going to be talking about that in my next video. We live in an age where we are going to have to start to think much more carefully about the air we breathe and how we manage that. And so while I'm in here, I'm going to be making a sort of crash course video series on YouTube about the air and how we interact with it and how our interactions affect the environment and about how that affects us. I'm also going to be doing an experiment to see just how long I can survive in here without causing any harm to myself. Let's find out. It is 3 minutes after midnight on the 24th of October. I am now sealed inside of this jar. So the project starts now.